Ladies and gentlemen, very happy December. Welcome to my favorite month of the year. Hey, I got 3 days left in my monthly fundraiser to keep Thor News up and running. So if you'd like to donate, I got a snail mail, a PayPal, a Venmo, a Cash App, and a Patron, and only $1,097 left to raise. So if you'd like to contribute, it would be super duper greatly appreciated. All right, what do we want to talk about first? We have a storm that is moving through the northeast, and then we have a storm that will be following it, moving through the northeast again, as it is going to be northeastern season now that hurricane season has ended. What a hurricane season it was. And I got to say with some pride that Cranky Weather Guy, shout out to him, and I have done a great job over the last 5 years getting everybody better and more prepared at dealing with hurricanes. And a special shout out to Prayer Warriors, Asteroid Fight Club, and Atmospheric Defense Team, because as we saw an onslaught of storms, we handled them way better than we did in 2017. It is the first day of meteorological winter, and you can see the cold in the cloud bands happening as the cold extends down into Houston and even Florida. I believe we had a low in Texas in Conroe of 25 degrees, which Texans will agree is a bit frosty. So yeah, everybody's getting into the cuddle season weather, I guess. You know, cuddle if you got them, or smoke them if you got them, or both. The sun is waking up and going a bit crazy, as we've had quite a bit of solar flares lately, and filament action. And who doesn't love filament action? I know I do. And so when the sun acts weird, Earth weather acts weird, people lose their minds. Plus, we just had a full moon lunar eclipse. So, you know, people are combine that with seasonal depression. And, you know, people are doing what they can to get by. And so I'm here with you trying to put a little sunshine into your step. Oh, I'm still a bit rusty. Hopefully you'll bear with me. Yeah, the sun has definitely been going crazy as we have quite a few sunspots all around the southern hemisphere of the Sol. And when I say quite a few sunspots, I mean quite a few. We're talking about 1, 2, 3, 4, and probably 5. And we have a possible coronal mass ejection impact on Earth. A CME launched by the November 29th solar flare might sideswipe Earth's magnetic field on the first or second, according to NOAA analysis. The glancing blow, if it occurs, is expected to cause no more than a minor G1 class geomagnetic storm. And this little sunspot did that. The sunspot responsible for Saturday's major solar flare has been revealed. And it is not as impressive as we expected. That's not what any guy wants to hear. Anywho, the sun is waking up. And that is good news because empires fall during solar minimums and rise during solar maximums. So expect things to get better over time, we hope. But with the grand conjunction of Jupiter and Saturn coming up on the 21st of December and a lot of solar activity, we are looking out for volcano eruptions and pretty big earthquakes happening, which we got a 6.4 in Russia yesterday and a 6.4 in Argentina yesterday, pretty much really close to each other in time. This one, the one in Argentina, was pretty deep, thankfully, and the one in Russia was pretty deep, so there wasn't a lot of major damage and no casualties. Thank you, Jesus. Danny of Rojos Gardening, letting us know the Semeru volcano in East Java, Indonesia, kind of around where that earthquake happened, had some spectacular pyroclastic flow Tuesday, the 1st of December. So yeah, we're kicking off this last month of 2020 with the bang babies. And so that is, you got lightning, pyroclastic flow, which is the super gray hot lava stuff, and earthquakes. So buckle up, because I got a feeling December is going to be legit. And I don't think all of our troubles and challenges are going to end with the calendar year, my friends. And so weather-wise, we got one storm moving out of the northeast, which is a mixed precipitation event. And then we have our next mixed precipitation event moving in. down into South USA and then moving across pretty much in the same pattern. And we will probably get stuck in that pattern for a while where we get some storms down in the middle and then they kind of bomb out up in the northeast. So let's be ready with our snow boots and our galoshes, something like that. And scarily for me, a guy who has heavy Jupiterian, Saturn, and Capricorn and Sagittarius placements, the next 20 days are going to be sketchy for me. Let's hope I survive. But hey, things somehow magically always seem to work out for me, so I'm not that worried. But look at that beautiful, beautiful solar action. So yeah, I mean, definitely 2020 has not been boring. Great news. Change is on the moon. And there's nothing more universal in our universe than change. This is actually Shanje, which is a lunar lander that is going to pick up some moon rocks and then bring them back to Earth. So the people who always think everything's fake, go ahead and say that this is fake. Although nobody's really paying attention. So why would they fake it when no one is paying attention is a question I always ask. Sometimes bad theories just don't hold up well over time. And I predicted we would see signs that the sun would be waking up in July and then definitely in December. And so I definitely think the sun is waking up. Remember, nobody really knows what the sun is going to do next. The sun is kind of like a magical mystery. And science hasn't spent a lot of time or money studying it. Hopefully that'll change. Also, remember life is a three-act narrative and that October was the ghosts of Christmas past. November was ghosts of Christmas present, and December is ghosts of Christmas future. So be prepared for weird stuff. And if nobody minds, I'm going to stay a perpetual optimist. Ed Piotrowski is letting us know that, yeah, we have officially put a wrap on the 2020 hurricane season. And I'm very excited about that because it is quite a hurricane season, man. I'm bringing you more exciting footage of the major fireball that dropped over Japan. No windows were blown out. Nobody was hurt. But it is a decent Christmas light, although it happened in November. Alexa, what's the temperature in Florida? I guess it's snowy dog. Dada Boo, Florida Wave Master, letting us know. Yeah, we got another one coming probably in about 5 days. Oh, the weather outside was frightful. But it's so clean looking. The monolith of Utah. Artists or aliens or both. Anyway, it does appear that the monolith transported from Utah to Romania. Although they look kind of different, you know. It's a mystery. One we'll probably dive into later in more depth. Also, the giant German penis statue is now missing. I can't wait until my sense of humor returns. But we're going to have all this Jupiter and Saturn in Capricorn energy until the 16th and 19th of December. And that's why I was warning everybody that these 3 years were going to kind of suck. Which they did. We're almost out of it. And so I'm keeping my spirits up. The last 3 weeks of Capricorn could get super sketchy, bro. Super sketchy. So welcome to December, and I'm going to do my best to keep everybody informed. And yeah, I kind of fallen off my game, but like I said, I don't know, the whole year has been so rough. We've been going so hard since the Christmas eclipse, and we're about to have our 7th eclipse, December 14th, 7th eclipse in a year. And so it's been crazy days, but I'm proud of everybody for making it, and hopefully Thor News will survive. If you want to help me survive, you can make a contribution or donation to my Snail Mail, PayPal, Venmo, Cash App, Patron. Got $1,097 left to raise. And I got to say, super duper absolute shout out to Mike the T, the Texas Angel, JB, Cody, Rose, and everybody out there over the last 8 years who has helped me keep it together, keep it running, and doing what I can to bring you guys the best information possible and to help us survive 2020, which was definitely a super crappy year. But hopefully things will progress to get better and that we will have a wonderful 2025, you know. But it's going to take teamwork to make the dream work, man. We are so divided and conquered right now. Everybody's sick of everybody. Nobody trusts anybody. We're going to need some divine intervention and miracles for sure. But I love you and I'll do my best. And I thank God that you guys are here. I am grateful for you and everyone. And hopefully we can turn it around and get to better days together. God bless everyone. And I will talk to y'all in the very near future. Peace out.